the hostages that run for war. Allah is taking oath and saying, Allah continues, verse number 1, 2, 3, 4. Allah says that these horses, sparks come out of their hooves, clouds of dust they raise, they enter the enemy. Describing that Allah is taking an oath of these horses, the steeds of war. They are without any fear, just because their master commands them, the person who's a horse rider. For the sake of the master, they enter into the enemy. There are swords, there are weapons. Irrespective whether the weapons, the steed keeps on going because he wants to obey the master. Allah is taking oath of this force. And in the ending he says, but man is ungrateful. That means the horse, to obey the master, it is ready to die. It is ready to get itself killed. Just because the master says go, it goes. Whether there's an enemy, whether there's a sword, whether there's a weapon, whether they're going towards their death, because of the master. But human beings are very ungrateful. That's the reason it's the duty of every human being to reflect on the purpose of creation. That why have we been created? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's the creator. He's merciful. He's kind. He's forgiving. He's just. It's the duty of every human being that you should worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Worship him and no one else. And this life, you have to remember, is a test for the hereafter. If we follow his commandments, we shall go to Jannah. If we don't, we shall fail this test and go to Jahannam. And we have to take care of the ni'amah Allah has given us. I'd like to end my talk by giving the quotation of the glorious Quran from Surah Al-Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 110, which says, "Kuntum khaira ummatin ukhrijat lin-nas." O ye Muslims, ye are the best of people evolved for mankind. We are called as khaira ummah, the best of people. Whenever there is honor, it is always for the responsibility. There is no honor without responsibility. The responsibility is mentioned in the same verse, and Allah continues, "Ta'miruna bil ma'rufi wa tanhauna 'anil munkar." Because we enjoin what is good and we forbid what is wrong and we believe in Allah. It's the duty of every Muslim that whatever he knows, if you know the purpose of creation, you have to tell it to the others. By what we created, we should worship no one but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This life is a test for the hereafter. Invite people to the truth, exhort them to the truth. Ta'miruna bil ma'rufi wa tanhauna 'anil munkar. And enjoin them towards the good and prevent them from going towards the wrong. It's the duty of every Muslim. Dawah is compulsory. If we do not enjoin what is good, and we do not prevent people from going towards the wrong, we aren't fit to be called as Muslims. We aren't fit to be called as khaira ummah, the best of people. I would like to end my talk with a quotation of the Quran from Surah Nahl, chapter 16, verse 125. It says, "Udu ila sabili rabbika bil hikma wal mu'azat al hasna wajadil billati hasan." Invite all to the way of thy Lord with wisdom and beautiful preaching, and argue with them and reason with them in the ways that are best and most gracious. وَآخِرُ دَعْوَانَا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ.